I think it's an unwritten rule among football managers. Kenny's probably better placed to answer this than I am, but Giovanni van Bronckhorst was under heavy pressure at that stage. Rangers were having a historically bad Champions League campaign. They were dropping points to the St Johnstones, to the Livingstones, to whoever at that stage. And to have a former Rangers head coach or former Rangers coach coming up, a man who knew he was high up in the betting to be the next Rangers manager, and for him to be appearing at Ibrox and, as Jim says, appearing in Rangers supporters' pubs around that time, probably was frowned upon by other managers and coaches and people within football because it's not really the done thing, Gordon.
And I know there was a lot said about the Partick Thistle goal, but I didn't realise it was a reason for fans to genuinely lose faith in Michael Beale, Kenny.
No, I think that's one thing that's a little bit harsh, I'd say, but I would definitely agree with the turning up in the director's box for that game. I thought it shows a real error in judgment. And you know, there was a lot of Rangers fans at the time, I don't think were happy with that type of kind of behaviour, considering when there's a fellow manager down there suffering at that time, you know, and he's been through it now. He's went through a real tough time, Michael himself, over this last few months. And at that time, I don't think it showed a level of class that you need to probably be that Rangers manager. But again, what I would say, with hindsight, it's easy. Mm-hmm. I do also know there was thousands and thousands of Rangers fans were on board with Michael coming to the club as a manager. And you know what? They were the same guys, same when Gio was coming in, because he ticked all the boxes with the ex-player, we're having the success, and that never worked out either. What the board have got is got a real, real tough task now to make sure this is the right call with the right man who comes in.